Geek Speak Radio Show. Hey everybody, welcome to another Geek Speak Radio Show movie review, this time around for Rise of the Planet of the Apes. First, let me do the non-spoiler review. Great movie, great addition to the Planet of the Apes franchise. This actually fits perfectly as a prequel. You can actually watch this, put in the original Planet of the Apes, and it makes perfect sense. And it actually, there are some connections there. Not obvious ones, but there are some very good connections. Alright, now that that's out of the way.
Spoiler alert.
Okay, spoilers from this point on. If you haven't seen it, turn away now. Everything pretty much works in this film except for one thing. And as I was walking out the theater last night, I heard a lot of people talking about it on their way out of the theater also. So I know that it wasn't just me. The Tim Burton Planet of the Apes that happened 10 years ago, 9 years, wherever it was. The one with Marky Mark and the Monkey Bunch. That one, besides it was a weak story, one of the things that really did not work for it is it was trying too hard to remind the audience of the original. And that was done with lines lifted right from the original Planet of the Apes. For example, take your stinking paws off me, you dirty ape. Damn them all to hell. Spoken by Charlton Heston, who made his turn as a monkey in this one, as an ape, an old ape. And you know, other lines like that and little things that were put in there that were nods to the original. That did not work in the Tim Burton one. In this one, it doesn't have any. It has a few. In fact, Caesar's, the main ape, Caesar's mother is called Bright Eyes. And those of you who are real fans know who Bright Eyes is. It isn't made obvious that, oh, it's a reference to Taylor. But, you know, if you're a fan like me, it makes you smile because that's in there. And that's about it. But then, they go all the way. Draco Malfoy is in this. Tom Felton, Draco Malfoy from Harry Potter is in this. Poor kid, he may be typecast. He's playing pretty much Draco Malfoy with an American accent. It's the same lines. I mean, he could replace ape or monkey with Potter. He's saying the same lines basically as Draco Malfoy, just with an American accent is all. But he's guilty of giving the worst line in the film, and that is the most famous line in the franchise. Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape. And the way I delivered it right there is pretty much the way he says it. No emotion, no nothing, and it just comes out of nowhere, and you're like, what? There's a moment that follows right after that that brings you back to the movie and sets it up. And it's supposed to make you forget it, but it's there. And obviously it didn't, because like I said, people were talking about it as they were walking out of the theater. Did not work. Other than that, everything about it is great. The effects, phenomenal. If Weta doesn't get the Oscar for this, then the Academy just doesn't know what it's given awards for. Andy Serkis should get some kind of Oscar, some kind of special Oscar for his mocap performance. As should the rest of the apes, but you know, really, Caesar, Andy Serkis is the one that carries this film. And he does a fantastic job. A lot of times in scenes where, obviously, there's not speaking. There's no language because it's apes. But you can see and after a while, believe me, you forget that you're watching a special effect and you actually care for these apes and you're rooting for them to win, to rise. But Andy Serkis, again, great job, fantastic job. Kind of like Transformers earlier this year, the action focuses on where it should be focusing, which is the apes. In a movie called Rise of the Planet of the Apes, it actually focuses on the apes. The humans are there. Yes, I know James Franco is made to be the star of this film, and that's the way he's played in the trailers and everything. But he really is a background character. The action focuses on Caesar mainly, but also the rest of the apes there. Besides James Franco, most of the other background characters, including Brian Cox, they're relegated to just bit players. For the exception of John Lithgow. It's great to see him back on screen again, and does a fantastic job as James Franco's Alzheimer's afflicted dad. And especially the scenes between John Lithgow and Caesar, the monkey Caesar, are spectacular. Fantastic. You'll love it. You'll know what I mean when you go see this thing. But again, everything else works as far as tying it into the franchise. Ties it in, like I said, perfectly. This one actually does explain how they became smart, the apes. And it's a very plausible, yes, I know it's science fiction, but it's very plausible in our day and age. Also, this one, and by the way, when you don't leave right after, there's nothing after the credits, but it's a little ways into the credits, like that directed by, and I think the title card scrolls up, and then there's an extra little scene that shows you something. And that's supposed to explain, and I think it does a good job, it's supposed to explain how we were wiped out and allowed the apes to rise. Doesn't go into detail, not any dialogue, as a matter of fact, but it does a great job of explaining how the human race was wiped out and allowed the apes to rise. And that wasn't ever explored or explained in the original franchise. And it's a great job of doing that and setting up any potential sequels. Now, this one actually is a prequel. If you really look at it, it's a dead-on prequel. You can watch this, put in the original Planet of the Apes, and it makes perfect chronological sense. Oh, by the way, Charlton Heston is in this also. Yes, you heard me. Charlton Heston is in this one also. Look for him, or you might miss him. So bottom line is, great movie, great effects, love the story. If you're a fan of the franchise, you will love this one. You will want to buy it and add it when it comes out on Blu-ray. And I think, with a few exceptions, this was really the final major release of the summer of 2011. I'm going to do a separate little, not review, but just a recap. A recap of all the 2011 films. Pretty good summer, actually, as far as films went. Do a little recap of that. Look out for that one soon. And I guess I'll see you... What's coming up? I don't know. Spy Kids, I think? Or Conan? One of the two. I'll see you for those. Maybe Contagion. Another one that I really like. So we'll do that and be on the lookout for some other geek events. And also be on the lookout for the relaunch of the Geek Speak Radio Show coming soon. More details, you can find them on geekspeakradioshow.com.